It is common knowledge that Nintendo is slacking when it comes to bringing their back catalog of classic beloved video games to modern hardware. So before the end of the world happens, let's all get to playing Nintendo GameCube, Nintendo 64, Game Boy, Wii, and the SNES or Super Nintendo video games for free on our modern iPhone and iPad, even the iPad Pro. Oh, and did I mention that it all can run at 1080p locked resolution or even 4K 60fps with an Xbox or PlayStation controller? Yeah, it's sweet stuff. Plus, it doesn't require a jailbreak. Let's install the AltStore first. First, in macOS, we need to visit the actual website, link in the description, altstore.io, and download for our respective platform the server. So for now, we're going to do macOS. I suggest that you just grab it from your downloads folder in Finder, and you need to drop this into your applications folder. As you can see, just drag and drop into applications. Once you have it in applications, go to your launchpad and find it in here. Open it, and then it's gonna show up in your menu bar here at the top. It's not gonna pop up like a normal window. Now it is time to us to connect our iOS or iPadOS device to our Mac. And once we do, it's gonna give us the popping of trust or not trust the computer. Make sure you trust the computer by putting in your device password. Once you do that, head on over to the AltStore here and hit install AltStore on the device that you have plugged in. And once you do, you're gonna have this pop-up. Please enter your Apple ID password. Now I know this is kind of sketchy, but no worries. I've been doing it for years and it is an open source software that everybody can check. And we verified, it has been verified that they do not keep or look at the information. This information is sent directly to Apple, so no worries there. But if you are deterred by it, it actually can be any Apple ID. It doesn't have to be yours specifically. You can even create a fake one or burner one. Now, once you have that installed, you'll have the icon show up on your iOS device. So you'll see it, but before you touch it, we need to do something. After that, we need to install the mail plugin, which is a step only on macOS, not necessary for Windows. On macOS, head on over to your alt server icon over here and hit install plugin. And then it's going to pop up this message, requires a mail plugin in order to retrieve necessary blah, blah, blah. You need this, okay? Install plugin, put in your password. Then once it is installed, mail needs to be opened and head on over to mail preferences. Once in mail preferences, you need to go to general and scroll or just look at the bottom where it says manage plugins and make sure it is checked off, alt plugin mail bundle. Apply and restart mail. Make sure mail is open once you do that and then you are set. Now on Windows, make sure you have downloaded iTunes from the apple.com website, not the Windows Store, and then search for it and open it. Once you have opened it or found it, make sure it is running and you plugged in your iOS device or iPadOS device and make sure you enable Wi-Fi syncing in its settings, you know, in the iTunes thing. Plus, make sure you get iCloud up and running. So that thing that Apple does, links in the description for Windows. Once you have that, search for the AltStore in your computer and open it or install it following the screens like I'm showing you right here. Once you have installed it, like any normal Windows software, you're going to find it in the little corner on the right side. It'll be a little like diamond thing, and that's the one you need to open, and I would enable launch login. Now that we've done all this, this step, you need to do it on Mac and Windows. So both macOS and Windows, you need to go on Windows to iTunes, on Mac to Finder, and find your device. Your device should show up at the bottom of iTunes, and on macOS with Finder, it should show up on the left when you have it plugged in. You want to make it so it shows up when it's on Wi-Fi. You just check off this box right here. If your device is not showing up on the left, go over to Finder, and on macOS 13.0, or newer, you're probably going to have it as settings. On older ones, it's going to say preferences. Click that, and then find locations, and then you will see your CDs, DVDs, and iOS devices. Check that one off if it's not turned on. If you've had any issues with the installation so far, make sure you go in the comment section below and let me know and I can help you. But before you do that, make sure you go to the AltStore FAQ. I'll have the link in the description or my full guide on streaminglabacademy.com to see if you can find where you misstepped or something, because it's actually a really simple process. Real quick edit, guys, if you don't see the AltStore icon on your iPhone or iPad, just reboot it and it should show up, or do the process again where you do install the AltStore and it should fix it. Now, finally, you're gonna have the AltStore in your respective iPhone or iPad device, and you're gonna click, and it's going to tell you that you need to trust your developer or the developer of this app. So that's easy. Go to General in Settings, and then go into Profile and Device Management, and then Trust. So hit, click, touch the Trust your Apple ID or the burner Apple ID email that you use to install the AltStore. So once you do this, you've trusted the developer of the AltStore, which is you, technically. For iOS 16, you will need a different process, but it's simple. Go to Settings, and inside Privacy and Security, you will scroll all the way down to the bottom and see developer mode. Once you turn it on, you will restart your iOS device and or iPadOS, and you will be able to open the AltStore finally inside your iPhone or iPad so you can get to installing Delta or Dolphin iOS emulators. Once you're inside the AltStore, you're going to be able to start downloading the emulators, which I recommend you install first Delta, which is the best emulator for GBA or Game Boy games with SNES and Nintendo 64 for iPhone and iPad. Inside, after you open the Delta emulator, you will see nothing but an empty library. This is where you need to add with the plus icon, and inside your files of your iPhone or iPad, locate it and add your ROM file to your library. Once added, you are set and ready to enjoy some real classical gaming on mobile. Now the big one. For Dolphin iOS, you need to do the same steps as with Delta Emulator by installing it and adding your ROM files to it, but with an extra step. Dolphin iOS lets you play, just picture this, Nintendo GameCube and Wii titles on your iPhone and iPad, but you will need an extra step, and that is JIT or JIT, just in time compiler, in order to run them. So how to enable JIT? In order to enable JIT, you're gonna need to be on the same Wi-Fi as the computer that has your alt server, so the one you pretty much installed the alt server stuff into your phone from. That Windows or macOS computer wirelessly should be able to, after you hit enable on your computer, you're going to be able to wirelessly activate JIT. The only time that you need to enable JIT to run is the first time you're starting a game on Dolphin iOS, or when your game has left RAM on your iPhone or iPad, which for iPad is less often, especially as you can see on screen. If you have a model with 16 gigabytes of RAM like the iPad Pro can have, it's never gonna leave RAM, honestly. I've had it for weeks, sometimes just sitting there in the background, playing some Metroid Prime and picking up right where I left because it has so much RAM. But for lower iPads or even the iPhone that has 6 gigabytes or less in some models, your mileage will vary on how often you need to enable JIT to run. And by the way, I did mention earlier in the video that you can use Xbox and PlayStation controllers, and you can even map specific buttons and keys, because you already know Nintendo GameCube controller wasn't the best controller out there, so some things you're gonna have to remap. But also MFI certified controllers like the Razer Kishi or the Backbone can work with this. You just need to hook them up or get the Bluetooth connection set up, and in my guide streamliveacademy.com I'll show you how to get that one going. And as you can see on screen right now, you just head on over to devices and set up the device that you already have first connected through Bluetooth to your iPhone or iPad, and then in Dolphin iOS or Delta, if it's a direct connection, you just need to switch the input and select the one that's already connected. If it's Bluetooth, it's gonna show up after you've mentioned, as I mentioned earlier, connect your Bluetooth device to your iOS device. It'll show up in the compatible devices. But that's it. Let's stop talking about it and let's enjoy some classical, awesome video games on the go. And avoid playing the stupid
pay-to-win games like Diablo Immortal and play some real quality games made many, many years ago. I'm in World 7 for Richie Rich Labs, and I'll talk to you all in the next video. Peace out.